Just finished reading my sixth book this week. Man, I just love reading books because they're so, like, packed full of knowledge, you know? Luckily for me, I know secret speed reading techniques passed down from a 22nd degree black belt kung fu master who reached enlightenment by eating an entire library. And if you want to learn those same secrets and read 18 books a week just like me, take my speed reading course. Only 14 easy payments and one hard payment of $19.99. Tax, title, license fee, shipping, handling, and itching powder removal fee not included. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to get back to gaining vast amounts of knowledge. Okay, let's be real here. The idea that you can learn to speed read, that is, learn to drastically increase your reading speeds and plow through more books than you ever thought possible, has been around for quite a long time. If you're in college, you'll probably see a flyer on campus at some point advertising a speed reading seminar that can teach you how to read at 900 words per minute, 1200 words per minute, or even beyond that, and countless bloggers have talked about the supposed techniques you can use to learn how to speed read.
And so much of it is BS.
So I wanted to create a little series to set the record straight on speed reading and also show you how you can actually realistically increase your reading speeds. And what I want to do with this video in particular is lay out the science of how reading actually works. Now, reading is possible through, wait for it, eye movement. I know, crazy, right? But there are actually several different types of eye movement. For instance, there's something called smooth pursuit, which our eyes do when we're tracking a moving subject. And you can do it right now. Just follow my finger on screen, and you might be feeling a little bit sleepy, which in that case, give me all your money. There's also vergence, which is what happens when your eyes move closer together to focus on a subject that's in the middle of your field of vision, and also something called vestibular eye movement, which is what happens when your eyes are fixed upon a fixed subject, but your head moves and your eyes compensate for that head movement. When we're reading though, our eyes move in quick, jerky movements called saccades. When we're reading silently to ourselves, the average saccades length is about 2 visual degrees, which equates to about 8 letters on a page, and this takes about 30 milliseconds to do. Now, when your eye stops and focuses on the text, that's called a fixation. To understand fixations, first you need to know about the 3 ranges of vision your eyes have. First, there's the fovea, which spans about 2 visual degrees right in the center of the retina, then the paraphovea, which goes about 5 degrees on either side of any given fixation, and finally your peripheral vision. Your peripheral vision is pretty blurry. It can make out shapes and movement, but it can't really pick up a whole lot of detail. The fovea, by contrast, picks up detail really, really well, and this is absolutely critical for reading. Most of what you can understand in any given fixation needs to be in that foveal range. Maybe 1 or 2 letters can be in the parafoveal range, but that's it. Now, the average fixation when you're reading silently takes about 225 milliseconds, though this is an average. The range is typically anywhere from 100 milliseconds to 500 milliseconds. Furthermore, your reading speed isn't just determined by fixations and saccades. There's also the actual cognitive processing time that you have to go through in order to understand what you just read. We'll get more into cognition and how your brain learns in future videos, but for now I want to make a brief note about your working memory, which is what you're using when you read. Research has shown that our working memory can really only handle about 4 chunks of information at any given time. A chunk being a bundle of information that is loosely connected through meaning. Chunks for difficult material or things you're unfamiliar with will be small, whereas chunks for things that you are familiar with will be bigger, but for both, the concept here is the same. Your brain can only handle so many at a time, and reading too quickly can result in a loss of comprehension. That being said, a good figure to keep in mind is that pauses for comprehension while you're reading will generally take between 300 and 500 milliseconds. So essentially, reading breaks down into a 3-step process. We have the saccade that moves on to the fixation, and finally the cognitive processing pause. Now, even though we have average duration data for all 3 of these things, it's not like we can just add it up together and get an average reading speed. A number of other factors come into play, including the fact that when we read, we actually skip a lot of the words on the page. Words can be separated into 2 different types. There's content words, the words that actually express the ideas you're reading about, and function words, words that express the grammatical relationships between those content words. Research has shown that readers fixate on about 85% of the content words in any given text, while they only focus on about 35% of the function words. On the other hand, reading also includes a lot of regression, going back to read over previously read words. Some regressions are small corrections when a saccade's distance is too long, whereas longer regressions will be to go over material that you already read once but didn't really understand the first time. For skilled readers, about 15% of their reading time will be made up of these regressions. Now that you have a grasp of the main factors that go into the process of reading, let's look at what a realistic reading speed really is. Some speed reading experts will tell you that you can boost your reading rate to around 1200 words per minute, which is a figure that many people cite John F. Kennedy reading at, and some even say you can get higher than that. But according to Keith Rayner, who's a psycholinguist at the University of Massachusetts Amherst and who did a huge study on 20 years of research in both eye movement tracking and reading speed studies, observations of college-level readers showed that most people read between 200 and 400 words per minute. And lastly, there's the concept of reading flexibility. A lot of the advice on speed reading assumes that you should be reading at a constant rate, but in the real world, this really isn't the case. When you're reading something where the concepts are presented more closely or the material is more difficult, you're going to slow your reading rate down so you can keep understanding what it is you're reading. And by contrast, when you're reading something where the concepts are more spaced out or you're already familiar with what it is you're reading, you can increase that reading rate without a huge loss of comprehension. So here is the final conclusion that I want you to take from this first video in the speed reading series. If you're reading between 200 and 400 words per minute already, you're in the norm. You're fine. My friend Shane, who runs the incredibly smart blog Farnham Street, is a great example of this. Shane reads about 3 to 5 books a week, but he's very clear on his site that he reads at an average pace. Speed readers who claim that they can do any more than 400, maybe 500 words per minute tops are doing so at a loss of comprehension. In general, reading at lower comprehension rates should be considered skimming. And that's what speed reading is. It's skimming. After a certain reasonable point, you get an inverse relationship between your reading speed and your level of comprehension. Which one is more important to you? So that is where we're going to end this video. If you'd like to dig a little bit deeper into the research I did for it, I've linked to a lot of sources in the companion blog post for this video, so you can click the card right now or the link down in the description to read them. Next week, we're going to look at some of the common techniques that speed readers claim will increase your reading speed and see if there's any validity whatsoever to them. And then after that, we're going to do a video on how you can actually increase your reading speeds. So stay tuned for those videos coming in the next couple of weeks. If you enjoyed this video, giving it a like definitely helps this channel, and I will see you in the next video. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching this first video in my speed reading series. Now, if you want to get new videos every single week on being a more effective student, including the further speed reading videos, you can click that big red subscribe button right there. Also, if you want to read a book on how to earn better grades, I wrote one. It's absolutely free, and I'll send you a copy if you click the picture of the book right there. Like I said, if you want to get the sources that I used for the research in this video, and there are a lot of them, as well as a summary, you can go to the companion blog post by clicking the orange logo right there. Last week was a little bit more of a philosophical video on how we should give more appreciation to people in all sorts of different jobs, so check that out if you haven't seen it. And if you want to connect with me, I'm on Twitter @TomFrankly, or you can leave a comment below. Thanks for watching.